Valtrompi is a hidden little valley in the north of Italy. I am pretty sure that the number of gun makers per square meter is the highest here in the world. You can find the Pedersol factory in Gardone. This is the place where one of the finest replicas and hunting arms are made with centuries of experience in metal and woodworking. Follow us as Dr. Pierangelo Pedersoli guides us through the complete process of manufacturing the stock for the muzzle loading and breech loading arms.
Well, everything starts from here again. Even the stock manufacturing starting from the from this office, the engineering office, where we have two designers. And they are preparing all the drawing for the stock. In this case, for instance, in 3D. This is just one example of the design we are making here. After that, we make the prototypes. And once we verify that the prototypes is matching our desire, we go with the production. And we will see all the production starting from the flitches, wood flitches that we are buying from United States, because we are normally using American walnut. Let's go to the other department of the company. And I think it will be nice, because the wood is a nice part of our manufacturing. So, let's go and see there what is happening in the other department, okay? So I understood you have never been here in the wood department. No? Oh? There's always a first time. Come on. As you can see, we buy the wood like this one. This one, all American walnut, you can see it here, see there, there. It's all wood that stay on place here for at least 4 or 5 months. We buy it when it is not dry yet, not completely dried, and we leave it here. See, the air can go through the flitches. After it has been cut, they put wax on the two sides, so avoiding the air to go inside again to break it. They put it in the oven and they bring down the humidity to 8%. Then we leave the blanks again another 4 months in packages like that, on, you know, like the turnover is almost 1 year. So the wood that I buy today, I may use it in 1 year from now, more or less. Well, we have probably 2 years supply always here, minimum. We have to, because then you will see upstairs, once we go through the how many stocks we already have. And then we leave the stocks there. I mean, they already dry, they have been worked already. But of course we cannot make 2 or 3 pieces only. We have to make hundreds and hundreds of pieces every time. We get into the wood production 25 years ago. We was buying the stocks from some supplier before then. We decided to do everything on our own. Just because we was making so many different models and we could not afford to make 2,000 stock from the same model, and which means having hundreds of thousand pieces. So we decide to do everything on our own and make a lot of 300, 400 pieces at a time, and we can survive with this. And this is already a big investment anyway. As I said before, Piero here is designing all the silhouette of the different stock on the flitches, based of course on our needs. The most important is the long gun. He's trying to get the most quantity of stocks out from the flitcher. The pistol are the minor thing, because you can put a pistol almost everywhere. Look at here, this is very nice, and he is obtaining here a sharp, probably. See here?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
This is a sharp here. And he was trying to put a pistol somewhere here as well. So from a flitch like this, he's getting three long guns and two sharps and one pistol. Well, the fibers must go in the direction of the barrel, cannot be perpendicular to the direction of the barrel, otherwise it will break very easily. Mm-hmm. And of course, when you buy the wood, he's also checking all the nuts, see? He's trying to avoid the nut here. It's outside. Mm-hmm. Because, and so, the wood is something that may present some defect. Look at here. This is very nice. And believe it or not, the nicest part of the wood is always, always, always close to the nut. Mm-hmm. Sometimes, consider you throw away at least the 50% of the wood is going to be used for the fireplace. Yeah.
Now he's marking the...
Well, now he's cutting this flitch in three parts, really. I mean, here and here, then he will cut it from there, just to avoid to move around a big piece of wood like this. Okay? Consider that now it's the humidity is at 7%. It's at 7%, and it's ready to be open. We take it down between 6% and 7%. The oven has been working for 8 days, and now I show you. See how many blanks we have inside. You can feel how warm they are already. We have around 300 stocks inside here now. So he's going to load it again for the next 7 days' work. You know, it looks nice. We have to put the wax, as in this case. Okay. And then if you want to see how nice it is, I will show it to you now. Need the luxury for the very nice gun, like extra deluxe sharps, LLLL, with gold inlaid. This beautiful.
But why do you need the wax on the end?
The wax to avoid that the air go inside and break it.
Ah, okay.
So, you know. Then we go to the turning, the wood, which is coming here. See there, it's a different pattern, this one. It's a different pattern, but let's say that you have the same pattern as this one in fiber, and then we put 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces, 4 blanks, and we are going to turn, see? So, this is the first, second stage, okay? Now, this is the beginning. These blanks are going to put it over here, and here we are starting the first operation. First operation is going to be the butt plate, one part of the butt plate. Then it's put in the second position like this one, and we cut the barrel, okay? See that all these tubes are, it's a kind of vacuum, no? All the burrs. They are going to go in a big seals container. From down there, they're going to be compressed. We make pellets and we heat all the building. This one and the other building upstairs.
But Essel is a green company.
Yes, no? Yes we are. You're correct. We are not throwing away anything. See, he's programming the machine now for a new stock.
So everything is computerized. Everything
yes,
is
yes, yes. We have three CNC here. And this is the result. Eh? See, very minor things. The importance of this, these are all CNC machines allowed us to have all the parts interchangeable. You remember you asked me how many stock we have in house? Well, let's say, of course, we are making enough quantity for normally 1 year, one or even more than that time. So, but at least they have to stay here after the work another couple of months. A free catalog to the first 5 people that tell us why the stock are hanged like this. Okay? Let's go. Now we are in the inlaying department. We brought the wood from the warehouse. Again, after 2 months, they have been staying there for destabilized. We take it here and we assemble all the metal parts on this wood. As I told you, see, he's cleaning now the lock area. He's taking away some just some edges. And here you are. See, we cut clean, just clean the part. And voila! I want to you to take a look at the inlaying. See, there's no air, which is one of the nice characteristics of the Pedro Soligan. He put the red on and checking where. If the parts are matching correctly the wood. Look, fagli vedere una cosa. See now, you see the red here?
Yes.
And nothing here?
Yeah.
No, important is both parts are red. So it means that this corner is a little bit higher than this one. Just polishing this now, finish. Put his foot. This is what makes the difference between Peder Soligan and some others. They are not just details. These are very important operations. This is one of the most important operations. And this is why we have two guys here. The other one is inlaying the sharp, the Hocken, maple Hocken. Somehow he's his teacher. And also in this case, it's not just a question to assemble the parts. Once they are finished, all our guns have a kind of inlaying, all our guns, from the first to the last one. And this is why they survive for a long time. But this is why they cost a little bit more than other guns, which is justified from these things. So, I don't know if you have seen already our other movie on the barrel making. With the stock making, we are closing the circle practically, because then we have, of course, all the CNC machine to make the other spare parts. But everything is done here inside the company from the beginning to the end.
What is this device?
Well, he's putting together, see, the tank and the butt plate to be sure they are very tight together to make the hole, to avoid that the parts are moving. See, we could make the holes with the CNC machine. Why we do not make it? Because we want to 100% sure that the metal part are tight against the wood. Mm-hmm. See, still with the vise, this is a kind of vise, of course. And then he make all the other holes. See, all the metal part has been assembled. And they will be then disassembled from here. First of all, the stock is going to be sanded. Mm-hmm. Okay. Then we will disassemble all the parts. We will put a number inside each part, so that this part, once they has been polished and the stock has been sanded and stained, they will be reassembled together. So same parts will go with the same same wood.
In case of accuracy, where the barrel, where does it have to meet the stock under here?
My stock. Oh, look. There's many different thinking about this, like having the wrench here, the wedges mm-hmm. here is mine, mm-hmm. That have to be tied. But we do that normally. It have to touch from here to here, mm-hmm. probably, and have one few tenths of millimeter of air here, so that it give a little bit of spring and bring down the barrel. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Here we are in the sanding department. The lady is making a sharp. I didn't talk before because the noise was too high. So the first thing she did, she was grinding the wood together with the metal so they are all at the same level. Then she went through two different sanding, the raw one, the finest one. And now she's going to finish it with a real fine. Already already had a serial number. So definitely this stock is going to match only exclusivity with this frame. Touch it.
Very smooth.
See, very, very smooth now. In lathing, so yeah. We start like this, and this is the finished. Okay, see the lathing. It's perfect, perfect. Okay, here we are in the staining department. It's outside the Pedersoli company, and we are bringing all the stocks over here once they has been sanded already. Some are sanded even here as well. As you can see here, we are coloring some of our Springfield and Enfield. So they put the color first, as I told you, this is American walnut. They are putting oil on, and it takes a couple of days to get it ready. And then, well, it's not finished. As you can see, they use a lot of steel wool together with oil and color. This is a blister wash, and this is another process, completely different. And we will take a look at this one as well. And we use this one for the, let's say, semi-deluxe gun, not for the military guns for sure, because, as I said, the military gun have to be, they must be more dark, more matte, the kind of matte finishing. Now here, we are putting oil on the new Lyman shaft. The lady is putting oil and color to bring down a little bit the, to make it a little bit more darker. And this process will be going on for quanti giorni? Questo 3 giorni.
Allora, questo dopo va a scolare la stampa calda, il procedimento si rifà anche il giorno dopo, 2-3 giorni.
So, this is going to, after the first hand, let's say, it go in a warm room. It will dry off, then she will put again oil for around 3-4 days. So she's going to do this work for 3-4 days until it will become very, 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 very. I'm doing that. Every time between one hand and the other one, she does this. Okay? She sends it again, make it smooth, and then she put oil again.
Why does it get so hard?
Because it's the process itself, when it's dry. Now she will put a little bit of wax again to make it shining again, and the stock is practically finished. So
how many layers of oil? How many times it is?
Four or five times.
See? And that's hot wax.
Yeah. Well, it's cold. See? And they leave it drying now.
Una mano al giorno, tre mani.
It's, they 3-4 hands. This is the maple. The process is similar, but not identical. See the grow here, the line here.
So you put some color first on it?
Yes. You remember the maple is white in terms of color. The grain, to have the grain coming out, you have to put some vegetable products. And then we put a little bit of oil and vernish just to make it shiny. But this is the result. We are very proud about this because I learned how to do it in the United States. We are now at the final station here, when the parts are going to be assembled again to the stock. We can see some kind of assembly, not necessarily are connected to what you have seen before in terms of wood. I mean, here for instance we are reassembling the Frontier Deluxe in maple. Okay, here it is. See? The patchbox, butt plate, they have been assembled already. Now he's going to assemble the barrel and the rest of the metal parts.
I hope you enjoyed this 25-minute tour that covered the nearly 18-month life of the wood in the factory. Stay tuned for the next part about metalworking.